Welcome to today's video. Make sure you visit podcastformarketers.com for more information. Over there, I have a really kick-ass course on how you can make at least a few grand a month on simple reoccurring revenue, right? And that's called Freedom Funnels. And make sure that you like this video and subscribe to my channel, man. I'm put out videos every day, so you don't want to miss what I put up, because I put out some pretty kick-ass content. And man, I always want you guys to comment below, man. I love, absolutely love all the comments you guys bring. Let me know what you're thinking. If you have any questions, I'm always in the comment section. I really love the community. Let's get into the video. All right, guys. So today I wanted to talk about advertorials. Advertorials are kind of weird. Like, Facebook doesn't really like them. Google doesn't like them. So you have to really make a web page look like a web page. So what I did was I wanted to show you how, versatile again. I use Landingi for this. You can do this with any page builder though, right? But I wanted to show how Landingi is very versatile and how you should build your advertorials. First of all, don't build it like this. What I did was I didn't have any content like just to write up right now. So I went and stole this from Russell Brunson, and his is kind of spammy. So you'll see he has his case study here, which is really good for Facebook. They like case studies. But I added on, an image here at the top, and also added this an exit pop. You see there, right? An exit pop. I'll show you about that in a second. And I added this banner at the top. If you notice that I have a menu as well, a hamburger menu, which is really cool, because you don't want them distracted. You want them reading your content. But I still have the social shares right here with Sumo. All right, and here is where you really need to give information. Now, Russell Brunson's just like that one trick and that one software, and he's kind of pitching or whatever. But here's go check out this live, a web class. And I wanted to show that, you could, these are called Johnson boxes. So put Johnson boxes here, right? And then put your call to action here. And then I put a little bit more information. This is like a headline here. It's like, I didn't have any technical skills. So you want to show that. And here's another call to action. It's a little Mediterranean mastermind with Gary V. Register now, right? That pop-up is when I did another tutorial. And then here's some more information about the myths and, I never picked up a book. I'm not smart, the economy or whatever the case may be. It's just all mumbo jumbo again. And then here's a little quote that I put inside of a box here. Again, click here to watch. So these are, and again, some people like clicking images and some people like clicking text links. So to have both of those on your page is really good. If you notice down here at the bottom, I still had my refund policy, other links that leave outside the page for Google and Facebook. I have my social sharing buttons right here again. So it really looks like a serious website. And that's how you kind of want people when they come to your website. I think Facebook is shunning the whole like using their colors. A lot of people will use their colors where this black is up top. I don't think you should try that anymore. But if they're coming from like whatever website, if you want to kind of like make it, model it after that. So I kind of have the Facebook colors over here a little bit. There's Facebook colors like in the blue up top in that banner. The Mediterranean is blue, just kind of giving them that Facebook feel. Learning how to write an advertorial. You see here, there's lots of blue here to make them feel comfortable. And there's trust in blue, right? So, and then here, you really want to give them real information, guys. I don't want to, show you how to build a bullshit advertorial. This right here will probably get you flagged because you're not giving them any information. You're just saying, hey, check this out. It's like one big ass, like just a long version of a landing page, and Facebook sees that, right? So what you want to do is really provide information like you would a blog. So you're saying, well, Sonny, what's the difference between this and a blog? Well, this is conversion based, isn't it? And you can A/B test this, right? And this is really quick. So again, with the exit pop, I'm gonna show you how I did that. This is really cool. So Facebook doesn't like pop-ups when you first get there, but an exit pop is fine. Okay. So let's jump in to how I did this. First of all, the slider is free. It's called the Lean Slider, and you can Google that, or it's right there in their, see their lean slider. It's right there in the knowledge base as well. I found it without going there. I looked at the knowledge base. It was there. But this is the Lean Slider. You just paste this part into your code. And then with the hamburger menu, again, that is in their knowledge base, which is really cool. It's just this much code, and you have to name some classes, and I'll show you those inside. And then the sumo, that's the little social share on the side. And then this is the exit pop-up. One line of code here, guys. Right, that they actually give you. So this is not some like serious technical thing, but what's really cool is how easy it was for me to put this together. So I want to jump inside and show you exactly how simple this was to put together an advertorial. And so this is the slider, okay? And so I don't know if you guys can see that or not, but it's, you know, they'll give you the code for this as well, but it's just slide one, slide two, slide three, slide four, slide five. And I just, you know, put my, where they are. That's it. Just copied and pasted where my JPEGs were. You should fill out the alt image. It gives you time for that just in case somebody can't see that. This turned out fine on mobile. I didn't design this for mobile because, you know, I just didn't want to, but this was an image and I just made that pop, here it's on click when you put an image in to show a pop-up, and then you can just add the pop-up. That's it. You pick one. I just picked my beach theme and that was a wrap. And then after that, this was really cool. So I don't know if you guys know, but there's an icon menu here. You just drag an icon up, you double click it, and then you can see there's a few icons that you can use, right? And so with that icon, they have you come here over in advance and you call it a class. So I just called it burger. Okay. And this right here, you have another class. It's just navigation, mobile, or navimob. It doesn't matter what you call it there. You just do that. And then when you paste that other code that I showed you before, just go look in the knowledge base for that. This is going to call up this little menu and that's it. And then you can make these linkable. Obviously, you can make that linkable. And that's it. That was all there was to that. And then this is just justified to make this look really good. I found this photo on the internet. And after that, it's just putting it together, folks. That's it. What you want to do is just after, you know, a certain amount of information, you want to give them a call to action, right? This is another icon, by the way. And this is a box. These are really handy. Okay, so that's a box. And just look at this. Actually, Russell Brunson had one, and I didn't like it. It just didn't look good enough. So I just kind of used his information. But this is just more text, another box. I duplicated this box, another icon. And I had my Photoshop girl do that. This Mediterranean. I really have plans on doing this, but I don't think I'm going to invite Gary Vee. All right, so, and this is just all text boxes and images again. So, guys, I mean, you might say, well, damn, Sonny, I could just do this on a blog. Well, you could, right? And here's the pop-up down here at the bottom. And what's really cool about this pop-up is you just make the section, because you see you can't see that down here, right? So you make the section, and then in this class, you use that little ML pop-up. And then here, you call it the pop-up toggle. And that's it. This will close with that little line of script. This will close the pop-up, and this will, that ML pop-up will call the pop-up up anywhere. And that's it. So you just make a section, and then you put those tags in there, and then paste that code that I showed you. Just, they have a video explaining it and everything. It's pretty cool. So this is, first of all, it's a template, and you don't want to make a blog for every niche that you're in. Maybe, and we all know when we're beginning, we change things very frequently, right? And For every niche you're in, for every client that you have, for every, if you have a client, you don't want to always just, you know, put up blog posts just for, and remember, a blog post is totally different from an advertorial. An advertorial, we want to get leads, right? So let's just say that you had an attorney that you want to start doing lead generation for. This is what you would do it with, right? You want to get lead gens. There's also another little trick I can show you as well that you could do for an attorney. And I'll show you this really quickly. So let's just say this said, this was a button and it said, well, let's just do it. Let's just throw this button in here. And on mobile, this will just actually make it a call. So you put here. So this is a call Mike now. Okay. So get your appointment out, your consultation. What you do here is you just put in telephone like this and then your number. So let's just say my number is. Like that. +1 310-555-12202. Okay. Save it and close it, and then I'll show you. Let's publish that. So if you want to do lead gen, where you're actually getting live calls right now, you can actually have them call out right now. So you'll see that in a second. This is sort of saving. Okay, so here we go. Let's refresh. So let's just say that you're doing lead gen and you want to call. It's going to ask you, do you want to open up FaceTime? On a cell phone, it's going to just flat out, do you want to call this phone number? It's really cool, right? So lead generation is what advertorials are for. So you have these for solar companies, attorneys, doctors, anybody like plumbers, anybody that wants to get, contractors that wants to get the phone call and get on the phone right now, you could do an advertorial, right? Because you're doing lead generation. You know, content creation for people or whatever is totally different than an advertorial. An advertorial is strictly to grab the lead, right? And you see that you're really trying to give them several calls to action. Now, what your plan would be is to place your Facebook pixel on here, right? And you can place a power pixel in here, and you should really learn how to do these power pixels. Maybe I'll do a video on that, right? How to really, really get those power pixels to show you. You can look and see how far they've scrolled. If they scrolled over 50% of your page, that's why you make them kind of long. Like if you notice software as a service guys have these long ass pages, right? They want to see how long you're going to scroll down. So you can, how long they scrolled, how long they spent on the page, and also a heat map to see what they were clicking on to be interested in, right? So you can get tons of information and then retarget these people because you know they were interested. Let's say they clicked on this, you know, Gary V photo for the mastermind, or they tried to make a call, or they just wanted to see more about Mike here, right? So maybe they did. So you can find out by retargeting them and then hit them again with the ad, right? And that's what advertorials are good for. And sooner or later, you're going to get like, 15%, 10% conversion, but then you'll start getting a lookalike audience to show you, hey, these are the people that actually converted. They're really interested. And you'll have like 100 to 200 conversions. You'll make your lookalike audiences, and then you'll know for sure exactly who your audience is, and you keep running this. And again, with A/B testing, you can change the headlines, you can change your call to actions, you can change your jocks and boxes really quickly. You just duplicate this inside of the editor, make your changes, and then do your A/B testing. I put this little jQuery thing in here to kind of give the page a natural feel. And I think I did a good job, right, of making the page look really like a regular website. I put my calls to action down here at the bottom, the social shares, whatever. So, guys, this is at freedomfunnels.com/Mediterranean Mastermind-Gary-V. If you want to take a look at it, I'll leave a link down in the bottom and copy it or do something different, change it up. But this is what a good advertorial should look like. You should learn how to write these, guys. I've been noticing, like, should I cold call? Should I do this? Listen, man, you guys, and this is going to be a part of Real Talk Tuesday as well. I'm going to do another video. But you guys are totally ignoring content. Everybody's ignoring the fact that they have to write content on how they're going to get clients. You're going to get clients a thousand different ways, and the advertorial is one of them. Throwing this up on a Facebook page, doing an ad or a boost post, and getting this out there to see who's going to, you know, get in your funnel here is really important, especially if you really did have a webinar going, right? This would be a great page to send people to a webinar from to get them involved, like an auto webinar. There's a million ways to get clients, and I noticed that people are trying to focus just on cold calling or just on posting on LinkedIn. You kind of got to spread out and do a few different things to find out what works for you, and advertorials do work. And if you're trying to get some cash in-house really fast, building advertorials like this for a lawyer and saying, hey, listen, I don't want any money up front. Just give me X amount of dollars per lead. Here's a couple of leads. Tell me what you think about them. If he likes the leads and says, okay, I'll give you $100 a lead, boom, you're in business. Find out how much it's going to cost for you to get leads. And then say, okay, well, I can afford to do this many leads right now. Are you going to buy all these leads? Yeah. All right, well, let me lock you in for buying X amount of leads. Then he may, if he likes your leads, pay you up front. Say, okay, listen, I'd like 1,000 leads by, you know, in a month. Cool. Pay me that money up front. And you know you're paying $50 a lead. There's your 50% markup. Okay. So advertorials are really important with lead generation, even for the clients. You guys want these social media marketing agencies. So even with the clients that you have, advertorials are really important. Coffee break. Ha ha ha.